Hey guys, the dude from Denmark here. Welcome to episode 5 of M14, the new core set that's about to come out for Magic the Gathering. More spoilers have been revealed today, so let's check them out. The first two cards I want to show today is two new Sliver creature cards, where the first one is called Gale Rider Sliver and costs you 1 blue mana to cast. It's a 1-1 and Sliver creatures you control have flying. The second Sliver is called Siphon Sliver and costs you 3 mana to cast. All Sliver creatures you control have lifelink. This Sliver creature is a 2-2. Sliver creatures now come in all colors, which I think people will be really happy about, since a lot of people thought that Sliver seemed to be only restricted to specific colors, which now is confirmed that it isn't. And I also think it's really nice that you can have all 5 colors of Slivers to make a deck out of it. I think these Slivers are we will probably see more Slivers in the upcoming spoiler season. But I do think that a Sliver deck is going to be really annoying to play against. Zach the Necromancer is a black human wizard creature that costs you 3 mana and is a 2-2. Whenever Zach with Necromancer or another human creature you control dies, put a 2-2 black zombie creature token onto the battlefield tapped. I really love this guy. Just run him in a deck where you have a lot of humans to sacrifice to get a lot of black zombie creatures out, which I think he seems really fun, and I think 3 mana is really cool for this creature. Banisher Priest is a white human cleric creature that costs you 3 mana to cast. When Banisher Priest enters the battlefield, exile target creature an opponent controls until Banisher Priest leaves the battlefield. Banisher Priest is a 2-2. I do think a creature like Fiend Hunter is a lot better than this creature, but all in all I think this creature is fine. On the show today is called Fiend Slayer Paladin, which is a 2-2 white human knight creature that costs you 3 mana to cast. It got first strike and lifelink, and Fiendslayer Paladin can be the target of black and red spells your opponents control. I really like the art on this creature. I think it's really beautiful. Also really like that he can be the target of black and red spells, which is a huge thing at the moment I think. So I think all around he's a nice creature that got some good first strike and lifelink and can protect itself from spells by black and red, so I think it's a fine creature. That's all I wanted to show today. Hope you liked this episode of M14 Spoilers. You can leave me a comment down below and tell me what you think of the cards we have seen so far and the blog in general. This Monday, the official spoiler season for M14 will begin, where I'll be making videos whenever there are new spoilers coming out. So if you're interested in this, you can subscribe to me. Until next time, have fun guys!